गुड मॉर्निंग वंस अगेन चिल्ड्रन, लेसन 9, हेल्पिंग अदर्स सेल्फलेसली ऑफ योर मोरल साइंस। सो इट इज पार्ट 2। सो चिल्ड्रन, हेल्पिंग इज अ वेरी गुड हैबिट। यू मस्ट हेल्प अदर्स, इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड इट इज रियली फील गुड व्हेन यू हेल्प अदर्स। एंड सो लेट अस कंटिन्यू। डजंट इट मीन दैट अ सेल्फलेस वर्कर हैज अ राइट टू डू एक्शंस without expecting fruits? This is a very sensible question, and equally sensible must its answer be. As far as the fruit of action is concerned, it is certainly there. No action can take place without leading to a result, and if an action is taken, okay, so children, you must do it without expectation, and if an action is done without thinking of its result, won't it be an aimless action? No, certainly not. Selfless work means doing an action fully understanding the fact that a doer cannot be his or her own judge, and so cannot determine the result of his or her action. It is God who is the greatest judge. So the worker should leave the determination of fruits to him. It does not mean the worker must not think of the fruit. It simply means that he or she must never interfere in God's sphere of action. He or she must be aware of his or her limits and must never cross them. In other words, the fruit should be left to the discretion of God, the highest judge. The action must be taken as a price of offering made in the spirit of devotion to God. This situation arose when Arjuna placed his bow and arrow on the earth and decided not to fight against the sinners because they were his blood relation. Lord Krishna advised him not to avoid action, which was his bounden duty as a true warrior. The Lord went to the extent of saying, those who try to avoid doing their duties commit an even greater sin. An example will clarify the point. Suppose you give some money in charity to a beggar. The beggar may spend it on wine, in gambling, and on drugs. Won't it amount to encouraging these social evils? Yeah,